There we go. Gotta go down, huh? I don't... What am I even doing at this point? Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Find navigation cards. Store around here. I think I just got somewhere. Anyway. Hoping to get close to the end of this. Hoping to finish this out before. Oh, Hallows Eve. There's a store. I need to dump some of these stasis packs. I got way too many of them. How is my... Oh boy, I have so many credits. Okay, Move. Flame fuel, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Fill up health. Get another upgrade somewhere, unless these are DLC suits to allow me to do the rest of my thing. Just a little bit. Well, that's fine. The whispering. Boy, a lot of flame fuel. Alright, so... I don't think I can go the other way, right? Started Guillermo del Toro's Cabinet of Curiosities recently, which I was very excited for. I am a pretty big Guillermo del Toro fan. Wow, these are a lot of locked. Huh. Wonder if they would be unlocked if I was playing on easy. Seems like a whole lot of them. One open. All right, I guess I got the good stuff in there. Okay, well, we're going back for this. Boys, let's go! Level 5 suit. Should have enough money for this. Wrong way. I would say, like maybe a lot of people, I first encountered Del Toro, Blade 2. Was a big fan of Blade. Liked Blade 2. I mean, it is historically known for, oh yeah, for the really bad CGI. In two spots, if I can remember correctly. One is the kind of like backlit fight scene with Nissa, I think her name is, Blade and Nissa, that just has completely like Gumby characters doing the fighting, completely unnecessary. And I'm trying to remember the other one. I feel like there's another scene in it that's really bad for CGI. And Del Toro, if you listen to the commentary, really acknowledges this fact. I don't think it's not a surprise to him. Did I get more pips? I guess not, huh? I probably just... Okay. Okay, my complete... Okay, we're probably done with suits at this point. He acknowledges kind of the fact that it doesn't look good. You know, he was trying to do something, it just didn't work out as well as he wanted. But still really enjoyed Blade 2. Really good horror action, and like, you know, it does the thing that, you know, Del Toro, I think, is the best at, and that is creating monsters. Like, I think the monsters he creates, the villains in that, I can't remember what they're called, they're just so good. Jump to my scoring block. What? Z-Ball. Okay, great. Oh, that's what's going on. This is like a locker room, which is why they're all locked. I really don't. Well, I'm sure.
Entering zero gravity.
Yeah, so these are the dark versions of that. That's why it took so long to kill them. Makes sense. Give me what's now here. So yeah, absolutely love Blade 2. I mean, look, I'll be honest, I really I like Blade Trinity, but I acknowledge it is not a good movie. Any other glowy bits? We can see places to go. I'm assuming we just have to leave now because we got the nav card. Something. Oh, no. No, thank you. I don't need to play zero.
Starting game over. Exiting zero gravity.
And then, say what do you think? Oh, good thing he had money on him. Hellboy, I enjoyed fine. Hellboy 2, I actually liked a lot better than Hellboy 1. Pan's Labyrinth is really where I absolutely adore that movie. Oh, that opened up. Oh. Crimson Peak, I like. It's not my favorite, but it is definitely, I enjoy it. Shape of Water is a weird one for me because it has, what I kind of like about Del Toro is he does a really good job of blending kind of like gruesome moments with just, you know, but without being kind of too grotesque or too gratuitous. The face. The face sewing scene in
Unitology is truth, and your death is the first we deterred by the physical methods of transformation. Soon you will be beyond any physical concerns. You must have faith, fools. This is what we have been searching for all these years. This is what we have been waiting for. Don't listen to them. Come back. How can you be turning away from the church in this vital hour? Do not abandon your faith. What's happening on the colony is not a tragedy.
No.
It's God. This truth is even more fantastic. On the planet below us, we have found a marker. God's plan is unfolding, and we are its inheritors. We will ascend as we always knew we would.
Because of this guy's
unitology is truth. And your death as the first phase. Be deterred by the physical methods of transformation.
Bathroom check.
Soon, you will be beyond any physical concerns. You must have faith.
Yeah, the face sewing scene in Pan's Labyrinth in particular. I love the practical effects in Blade 2. I think that is definitely the best part. The kind of super vampires, which I can't remember what they're called. I would say, other than the really bad CGI, the biggest sin that Blade 2 commits is completely ruined, like wasting Donnie Yen.
We have found a marker. God's plan is unfolding to reveal its inheritors. We will ascend as we always knew we would. Unitology is truth.
Interesting. Oh, I did have one. Interesting. No. I see that room for all this? Oh, yeah, I guess I know. Alright. Yeah. Alright. I like that.
Transformation. Soon, you will be beyond any physical concerns. You must have faith, fools.
Did I miss a door or something? Oh, I missed the nav card, didn't I? Nav card's probably in here. Oh, I gotta move the bunks. Okay. What do you think? I mean, I guess it makes sense. Maybe there's a door here or something. Oh. Seems like a really bad idea. Okay. Giving me a whole lot of stuff here. Oh, I can't shoot her. I guess I didn't need to.
Itself. Now it's time to play your part.
name that I actually have. Sorry. Excuse me, sorry.
Excellent work.
Now, come
with me. The door is unlocked.
Oh, jeez.
Isaac, be careful,
thank you.
Dr. Kine. A lot of what I've discovered so far has come from his records. The man has clearly gone insane. He might be unstable, maybe even violent.
Okay. Focus. Okay. Okay. Sense. Wow. That was a whole lot of shooting. Alright, you know what? Let's stick with what we got for now. Let's pray for a stasis. Do a quick savey-save. Alright. Look friendly.
You made it! Oh, thank God you made it. I've been following your progress. I know you want to repair the executive shuttle and leave this place, but escape is impossible at this point. The shuttle shock point drive is destroyed. No. Don't lose hope. At first, I lost hope. I tried to scuttle the ship, sabotage the systems. But Amelia, she changed things. The church, they think the marker is divine. But they don't know what's happened here, what's been released. Look. Look at this. That is what we found in the core of the planet. Mercer calls it the hive mind. It's the source, controlling the necromorphs telepathically. We were so stupid! But Amelia, she knew it could be stopped by returning the marker to the planet. The marker was containing it within the planet. Return the marker and seal the hive mind. Please. I'm sorry, Amelia. I bear much of the responsibility for this tragedy. Now, I must take responsibility for ending it. Atone for my sins. But you can help me. If you repair the shuttle and bring the marker back on board, we can end this.
I honestly don't really remember. I think I remember how this episode or this. Oh. Excuse me. My heart. Just like I planned it.
Captain's log, personal. I want to set the record straight. By the time this log is heard, my actions will have been vindicated. I'm a unitologist. By now, it's probably no secret that we shouldn't be in this star system. Just another illegal mining job for the company. That is, until the colony found the marker. That was when the church took an interest and chose me to lead this pilgrimage. They also ensured many of the mission crew were devout. My primary instruction was to get the marker up from the colony and on board the ship. Dr. Kine, the CSO, is an expert on the original marker and was tasked with deciphering this new one. He says he's making good progress. My decision to quarantine the colony is sound. They've got some kind of epidemic down there, and I can't allow it to infect the ship. Not with such precious cargo. Not when we are so close. Planet crack takes place tomorrow. We'll continue to decipher the marker, and when we return home, we'll pass all our findings and the marker to the church. The government isn't going to cover this one up. Altman be praised.
Interesting. This guy wasn't a fan. Your money. I start watching Cabinet of Curiosities, which is, I guess they are based off of, from what I can gather, which I haven't looked too much into this because what does it really matter? Looks like they're based off of Guillermo del Toro's short stories that he got, or they got, directors to. Film like 30-minute to 1-hour episodes about. Wow, no stasis refill. Huh? Wait, what was that? I heard a. Excuse me. Maybe it was just a clanging thing. All right. Save station. And so, I'm not quite sure what the cadence of the, like it said, like new releases every Thursday, but I think they had two episodes on Tuesday, two episodes on Wednesday. And I haven't checked, but I've been seeing discussions on, like, the next two episodes, so, like, episodes 5 and 6 online as well. So I don't know if it's just they're just releasing two every day or something. And then my initial... I'm sure this is fine. Let me just take this stasis then. As of now, I've watched 3 of the episodes, which were Lot 36. Was it Lot 36? What was episode 2? What was episode 2 about? Graveyard Rats, and then Autopsy. I mean, we're kind of at the point now where should I even
excellent. Wait there for me, I'm on my way.
To be honest, I think I remember what's gonna happen here. Am I literally just waiting for this guy? Lot 36, which had, what is his name? Oh my gosh, I can't remember his name. The guy who plays the leader in The Incredible Hulk, Mr. Blue. Tim Blake Nelson? I think that's him. I think he was in Ballad of Buster Scruggs. I need to do something, don't I? Through the window. Oh, hi. Is that you? Okay. So how many of these bad guys are gonna be here? What do you think? No stasis thingy over here? That seems weird to me. Oh, shit. was two, right? Oh, there we go. Pretty sure this is just gonna keep happening.
There's still time to make things right. The shuttle needs to be released before launch. The control platform there. I need you to guide the undocking procedure while I start the shuttle's engines. This will make us whole again. Hurry! I'll take the shuttle up to the flight deck where the marker's being held.
Hurry.
But we need that shuttle. Let's keep him on our side. For now.
If I were to guess, I guess I just needed to cut off its legs. That would probably have been enough to keep him there. Get to our next objectives and maybe call this one there. I think I have maybe one more go of this. Probably done, if I were to guess. Doing all this stuff. So maybe unkillable monsters are done with now? I'm not sure.
Your time has come. No need to be frightened. No reason to fight. Many have gone before us, and now it's time for us to take the voyage together. Transcend death. The future take its course. Join me as I gaze upon the face of God.
A room with a med pack. It's obvious. It really sucks when those things actually successfully do that. I don't know if I've maybe I let. I think it, you have to. I think it has to happen once, storyline wise. But I got two nodes. Can I do? I can't do damage stuff with this. This is a width. Do a quick save, because we'll always be saving. Oh wow, I feel like I misread the time on the last one. Store down here? Yeah, okay. Got that gold semiconductor. Could sell, I think. I'm hoping there's a stasis place over there. Right, I didn't pick up any stasis. I have pulse rounds. Sell those. Alright. On. It's fine. Alright. Sure. Alright, so right around 9 hours. So technically, we probably have about 2 hours-ish left, according to how long it takes to beat, according to the internet.
Mr. Clark, I'm approaching the shuttle hangar. You must find your way to the cargo bay. The marker, it's being stored in there. There's a cargo loading lift there you can use to deliver the marker up to the hangar. Please, you must help me with this. It's the only way.
Okay, so let me go to the store. Sell these things. Got a little bit of time. Where's my inventory? I need. The rich! Gosh, where is... Okay. Oops. Thing. I don't have to go back and buy stasis packs. I feel like I haven't had to do that at all. I'll push a little bit more. Just a little bit further. Workbench. Hi guys. You guys gonna touch? That was weird. I don't think I've ever had like an encounter like that where I could even potentially do something like that. That was kind of cool. Credits. Actually, kind of disappointed. I haven't had a stasis like thing in a while. All right. The marker. Hello. What the heck was that? Oh, Oh. Okay. Anyway. Could stop here. What if I didn't?
I restored power to the elevator. Take it up to the hangar bay and get the marker on the shuttle. I'm heading up to the flight deck now. Oh god. I'm just gonna run for it. Wish me luck.
Good luck. Alright. Buy all of the items in the world. Assuming there's one more big, like, monster attack. Might be a shooting gallery thing. Yeah, maybe next save I will. Committing to stopping at the next save spot. Flight lounge. Like a formal place. Sure, nothing bad will happen. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and call this here. I think actually let's just look at
hazardous anomaly detected.
Do it!
Quarantine activated.
Okay. I think we've done our time here. Save station. Alright. Hopefully I can clear this out on the next playthrough and get that up hopefully for Halloween. Means I might have to play on the weekends. Alright. Till next time, which will hopefully be the end.